And if you look at some of these ads, it's hard to argue with a straight face that the games were made for adults in the first place. Customizable feedback software. Push the stick that pushes back and feel your pain. And here's one that the most unbelievable of all, that says, kill your friends guilt-free.
Are you?
Oh God.
Alright, so what motivated me to try and get good at an older fighting game? And why specifically did I choose to play Guilty Gear XX Accent Core Plus R? Yes, that's the real title. Well, I got comboed into playing this pretty hard. The first hit of that combo was Ivy Sly, the developer behind Your Only Move is Hustle, that turn-based fighting game I talked about in my other video. He posted, quote, "The best fighting game ever made is only $3 on Steam right now." I don't know why it turned into Markiplier at the end there, but...
Hello everybody, we're playing Guilty Gear Plus R!
Yomi Hustle is an absolute gem, literally good enough for me to take the creator's word like gospel. So I bought the game. And while it was downloading, the second hit of this metaphorical combo landed. I found this video by Noah JD called I Did 10 Sidewinders in One Combo, and I'll just let the clip speak for itself. If you don't think that was cool, you need to go back and graduate cool school. Or at least get your cool GED. I mean, come on, look at that. Also, before I show you all my first few hours in Plus R, I want to qualify the title of this video a little bit. Yes, even though I have around 100 hours in Guilty Gear Strive, I still consider myself a new player in the fighting game community. But that's only because Strive is by far the only non-platform fighter that I've sunk that much time into. And I can count every other fighting game I've even tried on one hand. And I'm still cheeks at fighting games, so I'm gonna keep referring to myself as a beginner until I feel the label just doesn't fit anymore. And without any further ado, here's my first time playing the game. Now that I have everything set up, I can figure out who I want to play. I'm thinking it's either gonna be Anji, Sol, or Kai. This game looks so cool. It's so, like, PS2 era. I love it. Dude, look at this background. This is a really charming looking game. Okay. That might be a so bad guy, man.
A few moments later.
Yeah, I'm a so bad guy, man. Is that a fake gun flame? So we can pretend to throw a fireball and then run- That's cool. I really like that. That's insane! If I get good at the game, I'll be able to utilize that. Maybe. Alright. Let's go lose. We got 41 other players in the game right now. Not on my floor. Playing. Orsetti 4710. Send challenge. This guy seems like he's pretty good.
Heaven or hell? Duel. One. Let's rock!
I thought I'd include my entire first match without editing it down too much, just to show kinda where I'm at when I started the game. This is gonna be a tough watch for people who already play, but nah, you saw a new player in the title. You knew what you were getting into. When I told people I was planning on picking this game up, I got a lot of mixed reactions. Most people told me to be ready for a really hard time. People were acting like I was telling them I was getting into kickboxing. They were like, I don't know, be careful, man. They would usually go on to explain to me why the older games were so much scarier. Stuff like unblockable mix-ups, unbalanced rosters, infinite corner loops. One person thought it was insane that you had to learn different combos for different character weights, but he was a Smash player, I didn't really know what he was on about. I was intimidated. People were acting like I had to solve the Da Vinci Code just to play. But almost all of these reactions were from people that hadn't even played the game. I hadn't actually talked to any Plus R players before I pressed launch in Steam. But pretty shortly after the match you're watching, I went and I joined the Plus R Discord, and everyone there was super nice. Anytime I had a question about the game, somebody was always there to answer it for me. They even have a newbie role in the matchmaking queue so that you can find players around your skill level. What I'm trying to get across is, don't be afraid of pixels. Older games aren't that much harder, and they can be a ton of fun even if you don't have a full grasp on the mechanics. There's a ton of depth to the gameplay of Plus R, but that's only there for you if you choose to swim out that far. I mean, I could probably fill a small novel with all the useful stuff in this game that I'm not using, but that doesn't stop me from playing the game. Just because the skill ceiling's high, it doesn't mean I'm not allowed to enter the room. Like, this RoboKai clearly knows much more about the game than I do, but I still knock half his health bar off each round, and this is literally my first online match. And after playing a few matches with this guy, I went and I tried out arcade mode for the first time. Okay. Oh, you little British. Whoa! Soul's cool. I like Soul. If we beat arcade mode first try, I think I'd literally win $1 million. I love that. Oh, Andy looks so cool. Does he not have nipples? Is he a nippleless man? He had them surgically removed. Soul's cool. This game is cool. Dude, people say you can't get into old fighting games. This is great. Starting to get a bit of a feel for special moves. It is definitely tighter timing than Strive, but with keyboard, it's not really a problem. Oh, that was close. We're gonna beat arcade mode. We're gonna do it. God, the music's so good. Why Eddie kinda caked up though?
What you doing out here with all this ass? Double cheated up on a Thursday afternoon. Hella ass.
I love this game. I did not expect to have this much fun with this game. It's actually so good. That's so loud in my headphones. I really hope that's not clipping the audio. Or maybe I do. Maybe it'd be funny if it clipped the audio. So that's actually really good if someone jumps. I can just press J and my leg will catch him. It's like a anti-air. Viking? What? Whoa, she looks way different. Whoa, she sounds sick. It's actually nice to switch to another fighting game and I feel like I know kinda what I'm doing. I know enough to have fun, for sure. That move. Oh, are they gonna kiss? Whoa. I love this game. I'm in danger.
Oh! Oh!
Oh, he's saucing. I was really trying to grab him. Did not work. This is a really fun game. That sentence right there is why single-player fighting game content is so important. It's nice to have something to do other than multiplayer mode and training mode. Basically, all single-player content does is make sure that people that already really like your game play it more often, which can only ever be a good thing for the player and the dev. And I know arcade mode has been a standard feature in every fighting game since the arcade era, but I was pretty bored by Strive's arcade mode, so I didn't really have any expectations going into this one, and I was blown away. It really showed me just how important single-player content is in fighting games. That could honestly be its own video. Oh, it already is its own video, and three other people have already made it? Cool. Anyway, after my first day of thoroughly enjoying the game, I decided to gift the game to my friend Caden. You guys remember Caden, right?
There's only 10 people playing Guilty Gear, so...
On my floor, yeah.
And they all look just like you. And they all sound just like you.
You getting any of that?
Yes.
Okay, good. I sent you a pretty epic challenge.
So, play who you think looks cool, basically.
I'm in training mode too. This sucks. Get me out of here. There. Are we in?
Yeah.
Yeah. I picked the one with boobs.
Are you literally just playing I Know because witch with boobs?
Witch with boobs, big guitar. That's me in real life.
She's a mix-up character.
That means nothing to me.
What'd you say, you know?
She does.
I think she might have just said something really lewd. Can you hear my neighbors stomping on upstairs?
Dude, my neighbors were fucking spiking their 2-year-old off the floor the other day. It was ridiculous.
Spiking their 2-year-old.
Like a football.
Oh, I thought I was being cool. I was not.
I was cool instead.
Oh, the health. Where is your health?
Oh. I was trying so hard.
You're way too good at the game for how little you play, I'm telling you.
I see guy, I punch, I press button.
There's 6 seconds left. See, this right here, in my opinion, is the best way to approach playing fighting games. Just getting a friend and running an ungodly amount of matches in a row. I don't know why, but when I'm playing with somebody I can actually talk to, I don't ever get annoyed as easily. Granted, when I'm playing against Caden, I'm usually the one doing all the annoying stuff. Annoyingness aside, this is the optimal way to play fighting games, with a person next to you that you can shit talk with. This also showed me just how intuitive Accent Core is for newer players. Caden could take games off of me after 3 days of matches, and was able to pull off Gatling combos pretty soon after starting. It didn't take him long at all to graduate from mashing, learn his special moves, and start to develop a basic game plan. This was kind of a jarring realization for me after hearing people talk up and down about how difficult this game is for newer players. But you really don't need like a doctorate degree in combos to enjoy these kinds of games. I only spent $3 on this game, six if you count the copy I got for Caden, and I've gotten more than $60 worth of enjoyment out of this game. I had more fun in my first arcade run of this game than I did in the entirety of Dying Light 2, even though this came out on arcade machines in 2002. I thought about doing a section detailing the differences between +R and Strive, but I'm sure there's plenty of those already out there, and you can just find out by playing it for yourself. It's $3. I do think +R does some things better than Strive. I like the movement more, the combos more, and especially the online features more. But we're not talking about Stride today, we're talking about dang ol' +R. My kind of routine with this game was, I'd play a few online sets and then a few sets with Caden, a few days a week, you know, just enough to not burn myself out on the game. I was getting more comfortable with my character every match. I was noticing myself beginning to react automatically to punish certain things. I was improving, slowly but surely, by basically playing the game casually and having fun with friends. But a small piece of me needed just a bit more. My gameplay just needed a few more pinches of spice. I wanted combos. It is then that Seth-like Jeff set out on his journey, a journey towards a treasure trove of knowledge, the Library of Alexandria. For people who think the female beauty standard is having one eye and pink hair, possibly a samurai sword. The Dust Loop Wiki. This is a community-built information hub for ArcSys games. Anything Guilty Gear, you find it here. Anything from your character's moveset, starting guides, and of course, combo guides. The namesake of this wiki comes from Soul's Dust Loop combo. He uses his jumping dust attack to loop you in the corner for massive damage. This combo is what I actually came here to learn. But that was not as easy a task as I envisioned it to be. The first thing I had to do was learn numpad notation. It was always something I was aware of, but just avoided for fear of its complexity and bunch of numbersness. I would try and look up a combo sheet and it would just look like this. And I would just go, incomprehensible, have a nice day, and close out of it. I've seen memes about this kind of thing too, so I know I'm not alone here.
Progress report.
It's an older code, Skipper. I can't make it out.
You, higher mammal. Can you read?
No, Phil can read, though. Phil?
Use overdrive for standing punch, kick, slash, head slash, dust, kick, slash. Dragon install!
But this lack of knowledge was very quickly remedied by me literally looking down at my keyboard numpad and realizing 5 is neutral. So after putting my huge brain notation reading skills to good use, I hopped into training mode. The website has this combo listed as medium difficulty, but it took me 2 solid weeks of practice to get it consistently. Keep in mind, it's not like all I would do is grind this one combo for 2 weeks. I have a job. I do training mode for like 10 minutes before I start doing quick matches or Discord sets, and I would spend most of that training mode time learning this dust loop combo. But this very process of combo learning is actually why a lot of people bounce off of fighting games. The average person probably doesn't want to dedicate weeks of time and effort to funny soulcornerloop.mp4. And you know what I have to say to those people, honestly? Yeah, fair enough. Yeah. Understandable. I think a big reason I personally don't find training mode all that tedious is because I have hobbies that are weirdly similar in terms of the learning process. For example, one of the more consistent hobbies throughout my life has been balisong flipping. In balisong flipping, you gotta learn individual moves, learn how to do them consistently, and then weave those moves into a sequence. And this trick sequence is of course called a combo. And the only way to get consistent with these combos is by frequent practice. Just try to learn from your mistakes and not drop the combo the same way twice. And in the case of balisongs, try not to drop the combo on your foot. And you know, I could probably draw similarities to my numerous other hobbies as well. Most of them involve learning through messing up the same way over and over again until you hit a point where it clicks and you just get it. And everybody goes through that process at different speeds. Here's the replay of me hitting the dust loop combo in a match for the first time. And I didn't do the follow-up right, but I did the dust loop itself right. I got into it and out of it. Though it counts, okay? Shut up, it counts. Don't be fooled by the clip, I'm still getting my ass handed to me most of the time. Despite that, I've enjoyed almost every match I've played. And I'm sure at least some of you are wondering why I'm not doing the whole 24-hour thing in this video. And the answer to that question is very simple. Game too fun. Game too fun. I mean, of course it's fun in the gameplay sense, but you've heard me talk about gameplay stuff for like the last 3 videos. These games also excel in terms of the soundtrack and the art, and I almost feel bad that I've never talked about this aspect of the franchise before. I mean, the amazing art and music is just so pervasive that I never really felt the need to talk about it. I mean, it's right there, man. But it's a huge reason I got into Guilty Gear as my first anime fighter. All the character designs are so distinct from one another. The soundtrack kicks ass. It was good enough for me to start listening to metal a lot more, just like the idea of a heavy metal themed fighting game is so cool, and that is Guilty Gear in a nutshell. Obviously there's a lot more to it than that, but it's just something I really appreciate seeing. Another interesting part of going back to Plus R is seeing the characters closer to their original designs. For example, seeing Faust being a complete goofball in this game instead of the terrifying, long, cryptid man that I was so used to was a bit jarring. Both approaches totally work though. He looks great in both renditions, even if I have a skill issue against him personally. At this point I have about 60 hours logged into Plus R, and I think I've made massive improvements in that span of time, but I'm far from being done. This game is very deep and complex, to the point people often refer to it as a forever student fighting game, but the complexity doesn't make it unapproachable. Anyone can pick this game up and learn it. I did it, and I've gotten three other people into the game too. All of them picked it up just as quickly as I did, if not faster. And at the time of recording this, I'm not at the skill level that I want to be at currently, but I'm a lot closer than I was when I started. Let me prove it. Needless to say, I really enjoyed my time in Plus R, and I plan to enjoy countless more hours in this silly little 4x3 aspect ratio-ass game. I think it's pretty obvious at this stage that I've become a full-on Guilty Gear fan. I wasn't expecting to like Strive as much as I did when I picked it up a while ago, but it was my gateway game that got me into the FGC. I play Plus R and Strive almost every day now. I could give this franchise, and specifically this game, infinite praise, and it would deserve every single bit of it. This absolute masterpiece of a game goes on sale for $3 on Steam all the time. There's really no excuse not to pick it up. Maybe you don't love it as much as I do, but that's okay. It's still definitely worth a shot. It's a challenging game for sure, but it's nothing you can't handle. If I can learn it, anyone can. And if you want to run some Plus R with me, join the Seth Like Jeff Discord. I'm in there doing matches pretty much every day. There's a ton of newer players in there too if you don't want to jump straight into quick match. But anyway, Plus R good. Play Plus R. Alright, propaganda over. I'm really busy. I need to get back to my third Elden Ring playthrough. Thanks for watching, bye!